Okay. Hi everybody, and welcome to today's webinar, 8 mistakes that will ruin your inbound marketing campaign. In today's webinar, we will be talking about inbound marketing mistakes, 8 common. And the webinar will be about 35 minutes long. I will be speaking for about 25 minutes, and then we'll end the webinar with a Q&A session. So whenever you get a question, ask it in the chat box to the right, and I will answer all questions that I have time for in the end. And before we begin, I just want to state that this webinar is for B2B marketing people in IT and tech industry. Yeah, my name is Jacob Hamar, working as a team manager for one of our inbound teams here at Bright Vision. Jag har ingen dålig wifi connection. Jag kan testa och slå i de här. Då testar vi. I've heard that there was some audio issues. I hope that's fixed now. Yeah, I'll just start over. Hi everybody, and welcome to today's webinar, 8 mistakes that will ruin your inbound marketing campaign. This webinar will focus on 8 common mistakes in inbound marketing, and the webinar will be approximately 35 minutes. I will talk for about 25 minutes, and then we'll end the webinar with a Q&A session where you can ask questions. If you get any questions that you want to ask during the webinar, feel free to do so in the chat box to the right here. Before we begin, I just want to say that this webinar is created for B2B marketing people in the IT and tech industry. My name is Jacob Hamar, working as a team manager for one of our inbound teams here at Bright Vision. To you who are new to us, Bright Vision is a B2B marketing agency that help IT and tech companies in Europe to grow. We've been doing so for 20 years now, and we're fortunate to work with a lot of exciting clients, some of which you can see here. Our services span both outbound and inbound activities. Here are some examples of, or here are our services. We're a full service marketing agency, and we strongly believe in the integrated approach where inbound and outbound marketing can go hand in hand and pretty much empower each other. We niche ourselves in catering to the IT and tech industry, which our clients usually appreciate, that we really understand their challenges and their target group within this industry. Also, we understand that marketing today is measured in how much business we can generate. It's all about ROI at the end of the day. Everything we do is aligned with that goal. Before we start jumping into the common mistakes here, I just want to say that inbound marketing is hard. It is not easy to get everything right all the time, and mistakes are made. I have surely made mistakes, and I'm sure you have as well sometime. The important thing is that you learn from them. Even though I will be talking about a lot of mistakes and pretty much don'ts when it comes to inbound marketing, there's no shaming here. Hopefully, you can learn something from it, and I will be talking about both the mistakes that are easily made, but also how to avoid them. So without further ado, let's go. The first common mistake we see a lot of in inbound marketing campaigns is ad hoc marketing, or having an ad hoc approach to marketing, which means that you're not being strategic. Instead, your marketing is based on an ad hoc approach where decisions are made without thinking of the bigger picture. And creating inbound campaigns demands a lot of decision-making. What content to use, who to target, what images to use, what message and value propositions to go to market with, how leads should be followed up on, and much more, as I'm sure you know. But when it comes to ad hoc marketing, decisions are made for the wrong reasons, you can say. Here are some examples of ad hoc marketing decisions. It could be that you're reusing existing content in your inbound campaign that you weren't involved in the creation process of. And it's cheaper to use. You don't have to create anything new. You don't have to spend time creating that. But there are also downsides in utilizing content that's not created for your campaign. And another thing companies do is copying a competitor because it should work for us as well, which is never a good idea. It's never a good idea to steal ideas to begin with for many reasons. Potential bad will is one thing, but more importantly, you will be able to create something better yourself if you start from yourself. Another thing is doing the same campaign over and over again by routine because it's how you've always done it. And it's how you've always done it is not a successful way of thinking, especially not in marketing when everything's changing at a very fast pace. So always be ready to create something new, to try out something that you've never done before. And the last example here is running webinars. Webinars have been increasingly popular, especially now after the pandemic. Webinar is a great content format. It might be the way to go for your inbound marketing campaign, but the reasoning behind choosing a webinar should never be that other people are doing it or that's what you're supposed to do right now. So how to avoid this then? To begin with, it's necessary to set goals for all levels of your marketing. I'm sure you set goals for your marketing plan or on a yearly basis, but set goals for long-term marketing, but also for each and every campaign and activity that you execute and launch. And when you've set that goal, you can make decision. Every decision that you make should be should point towards that goal, should cater to that purpose. So use the goal of the activity as a compass for all decisions you make. It can be decisions, very practical decisions like should we create new content? What target segment should we go after? What media channels should we launch the campaign in, and so on. And without the goals, the overall goal for the activity, it's very easy to cut corners, as we saw in the examples, like because it's cheaper. And it's important to know that that's decreasing the power of your campaign. It's not it won't be as effective as it can be. So set goals and don't forget them when you make very small decisions, but in a lot in the bigger picture can make a big difference. And the second mistake we see a lot of is utilizing the wrong content. You think your campaign and the content in it should be a success, but the results point towards the opposite. And more often than not, the content is the problem. So for this common inbound marketing mistake, I found three usual content mistakes in itself. The first being you're writing what the potential customers want to read, but it might not be what the audience really wants. Sometimes we see like glorified sales pitches. They call it an ebook, but it's pretty much a product description. But and that's I can definitely understand that that's what you want to talk about, but is it what your buyer persona or target audience wants to learn more about? Are they ready for that? The second content mistake we see a lot of it is that the content itself is not tailored to a specific buyer persona. So it might not be But it's important to always create some sort of buyer persona when creating content. That makes it a lot easier to create content that really engages and really is appreciated in the target audience. And third, it doesn't look good. So you need to create content that's easy to digest, regardless of format, really. Your content needs to look nice and just be fun to listen, watch, or read. And it's often overseen. And how to avoid this then? I would say that you should start with creating a buyer persona to use for your content creation. And the buyer persona, this semi-fictional characterization of your ideal buyer, should state what type of company the person is working at, their current situation, how your solution, service, product can help the buyer persona, what the buyer persona wants to learn more about, and where in the buyer's journey the persona is, i.e., how close to a purchase decision is this buyer persona. And when you've done that, you need to choose the type of content and the format, content format that suits your buyer persona. So, for example, the format of the content itself is very important to match into the buyer's journey. So, for example, animated videos and infographics and lightweight content like that is great for awareness stage, the early stages of the buyer's journey. And for the later stages, when a person is closer to a purchase decision, webinars and product sheets or comparison charts could be great content. And this is a bunch of balancing acts. It shouldn't be too, your content shouldn't be too product specific, not too generic, not too heavy, not too light. Should it be gated or not behind form? So it is a lot of decision. But with the buyer persona and mapping out the buyer's journey makes this a whole lot easier. Third mistake here is that you're not setting aside the resources needed. You want to create the perfect campaign, but the time and money needed isn't put into it. Sales is not contributing, product experts don't have time, and you have limited bandwidth yourself. And if everyone involved doesn't take the time needed, it won't be a great campaign. It won't be the campaign that you want to create. But in theory, this is quite easy to fix. You need to set aside resources for inbound marketing campaign. Definitely time and probably a bit of money, at least ad budgets, for example. And there's really no way around that. And if you don't put the time needed into one specific campaign, you can damage your long-term objective, which often is like marketing should generate return on that investment. But cutting the corners or spending too little time in the campaign production, for example, is not catering to that purpose. It damages your long-term objective. And there is a trade-off between time and quality. You can't create really the perfect piece of content in no time. So it's easy to forget that and try to do everything as fast as possible, but there is a trade-off there. And inbound marketing is an investment. So if you put the time in it, it will generate ROI. Which leads us to the fourth mistake. You don't know how to calculate the ROI. You're proud of your inbound campaigns, but when somebody asks about the ROI on the marketing, you're not sure how to answer. Stakeholders will think twice about the next initiative as the return has not been proven from the previous campaign. And this is all about measuring the campaign as much as you can. It's both like CTR, clicks, leads generated on the marketing side, but to calculate the ROI, you also have to have information about the sales process. So the length of the sales cycle, the average deal size, close rate on opportunities, how many leads, for example, turn into a meeting is one metric, and there's much more. And to get that information that a marketing manager might not have, you just have to ask the sales team. They know this. So include the sales team, which also drives us to the fifth mistake here. You don't align with sales. And it's the classic gap between marketing and sales. Marketing don't get support in their inbound campaigns, and sales feel like marketing don't generate any quality leads or opportunities for them. And this is all about engaging with sales, planning the campaign with sales, producing, executing the campaign with sales. So in the planning process, salespeople have a lot of information and knowledge about the buyer persona and the market right now, because they are in tight dialogue with potential customers and existing customers. And they also have good knowledge about the value propositions and the offerings available, which is very important in the production of a content piece, for example. And by engaging with sales early on in the campaign process, it's much more easy to get them on board in the last stage of the campaign, when the campaign is actually live, which is really where you want them to be involved, when you can hand over your leads to them for follow-up. And do that on a weekly basis. So when you set up or when you're launching a campaign, set up weekly meetings or set a reminder to yourself on a weekly basis to send over all the leads that are ready to be engaged with by sales. And if you do your job right with the help of sales, you make it easy for sales to sell. And this is related to the sixth mistake, the technical foundation for lead management. And this is pretty much about your not having the systems and tech set up needed to make the most out of your campaign, and again aligning with sales. So you generate new leads and contacts, but the contacts are not prioritized by sales and does not get the nurture needed for becoming a sales qualified lead or becoming ready to be engaged by with sales. So tech and systems are necessities for effective inbound campaigns. Marketing automation systems, for example, can, with the help of that, you can implement intelligent nurturing, like sending email nurtures, workflows for a longer period of time. And you can also automate the handover to sales, which makes it easier for you, and sales know that, okay, all automatic handovers of leads, those leads are actually worth following up on. So you get this tight, you're bridging the gap between marketing and sales. And this creates this problem about having one big system for every little task, or having several systems for those small tasks. So, and that's a balancing act in itself, but a marketing automation system can help you out a lot in this. And there's no right tool for everyone, depending on company size, how many employees in marketing and so on, is factors that plays a role here. But I can only recommend that you spend time researching solutions for your needs. It will be worth it in the end when you find a marketing automation tool or a CRM that suits both, that cater to both sales and marketing's needs. And you can, of course, ask us for help as well. And seventh mistake then, you don't optimize your campaign. You spend weeks and months creating a campaign you look forward to launching, but the target audience doesn't engage as you thought it would. After the campaign is launched, you say, too bad, the results doesn't look that good, but perhaps the next campaign will go better. And this is really a waste of work, waste of a good campaign, just because the results might not be great the first week. Doesn't, or if the results aren't great, doesn't mean that they can't be optimized to become at least good or even great. So this is a turn you need to turn your let's see attitude when you're launching a campaign to a let's go attitude. So when you're launching the campaign by essentially launching the ads, you need to monitor the campaign closely. So you look at all the metrics and KPIs and be ready to make adjustment and optimizing the campaign. And all parts of all campaigns can be improved at any time. So emails, ads, landing pages, content, etc. can be optimized. And it's really about making a change that point one key metric to the right direction. But with that said, don't lose the campaign storyline. You don't want to optimize so the campaign loses its storyline. It still needs to be a coherent campaign at the end of the day. And today, it's very easy to use data to find out where your campaign is underperforming. This, again, you need some systems to do this, but I think most systems today, or just Google Analytics, can provide you with this information. So use data to find out where your campaign is underperforming. So, for example, landing pages. If the ads perform well and people get to your landing page, they click on the ads and they get to the landing page, but they don't take the action that you want them to do, perhaps filling out a form, then you pretty much can draw the conclusion that the landing page is the problem. The ads are working well, but for some reason, people don't take the action desired on the landing page. So that can be optimized. And the same goes for ads. If your ads get impressions and the right people are looking at them, but people don't click, okay, then you know that there's something on the ad level that can be optimized. There's room for improvement there. And the same goes for media channels. If you launch a campaign on Facebook and LinkedIn, for example, and you have the same ads, similar target audiences, and you see that one media channel performs better than the other, be ready to reallocate budget to the media channel that best serves the purpose. And emails, if you send out emails to a segment and you see that the open rate is bad, then the open rate is an indicator of your subject line not performing. So try to change the subject line and see if the open rate goes up. Then you have optimized the campaign. And the same goes for target audience. On all larger ad platforms, you can see a breakdown of what people clicks or take actions more than the average. And I would suggest that you can remove, on LinkedIn, for example, if there's some titles in your target audience that don't click or click less than the average, you should remove those titles if they're not that important to you. So that's one way to optimize on a target audience level as well. And the eighth and last mistake here today is that you focus on new leads only. You use the terms inbound marketing and lead generation interchangeably. You measure the success of your inbound marketing campaign solely on the amount of leads generated. And this is not the best way to look at it because you miss out on a lot of good side effects. So inbound marketing is not equal to lead generation. Lead generation is a part of inbound marketing, but the umbrella term inbound marketing includes more than just lead generation. So inbound marketing has great side effects like positioning your brand in the market, increasing brand awareness, ungated content can improve your SEO, etc. And inbound marketing is more like a tool for you to use. You can run inbound marketing campaigns on other segments than unknown contacts, if you can see it that way. Inbound marketing is great for finding cross-selling and upselling possibilities to existing or known contacts. So here are some segments of your database today that are pretty easy to target with an inbound marketing campaign. Let's say that it's an email marketing campaign, that and you create that campaign and focus it on existing clients. So perhaps they can purchase more of the same product or solution or another service that you offer. And the same goes for lost clients. A specific inbound marketing campaign might go well with them. And people that you have sales dialogues with, but you haven't closed the deal yet. Should you show ads on LinkedIn to relevant people at this specific account, perhaps? And just forgotten clients, people that is in your CRM or marketing automation tool, but no one really knows. It's been a long time since you engaged with them. They haven't been clients for a while. Can you create an inbound campaign or email marketing campaign to them with a specific messaging? These four segments are low hanging fruits for you to target with an inbound marketing campaign. And I can only recommend that you try out this. Activities targeted towards these segments are often like smaller, easier to execute, and can be executed faster. You don't have to wait for new leads to be generated. You already have the contacts in your database. Yes, and that's pretty much it regarding the mistakes. And I've gathered some key takeaways that if you were to remember four things from this webinar, these are the four things that I hope you will remember. First, set goals for all levels of your marketing activities and have them in mind when making every single decision. And make decisions so pointed towards that overall goal. And create content for your buyer persona, not for yourself. Don't write what you want to write. Write what wants to be read, rather. It's all about putting yourself into the buyer persona's shoes. That's often overlooked. And the right systems make your work easier and your campaigns better. And a lot of other benefits, like aligning with sales, for example. So invest in tech. And lastly, you need resources to create great campaigns. It takes time. It takes perhaps money. It definitely takes different competencies, product experts, solution experts, sales, yourself as marketing manager, perhaps someone who produces assets like copywriters, designers. Somebody has to create the landing pages, etc. You can't really cut any corners when it comes to resources, and time being the most important resource that you have available. And to sum up, you can use us for, of course, Bright Vision, to increase your bandwidth. If you feel like you're lacking competencies or just the time to produce content, feel free to reach out. We create inbound campaigns, big and small, and can help out in any part of your inbound marketing campaign. If you don't want to do it yourself. So that was it for me. I'm just going to see here if we have any questions. Apart from I can't hear anything. Here's a question. It's hard to have the right expectations on an inbound campaign. What's your best advice on how to get marketing, sales, and CEO to align around one goal, i.e., so everyone can have the right expectations? Yeah, that's a very good question and something that we see isn't always that easy, because everyone has their own agenda to push or their own interest. What's important, I think, is educating, and it's not like you shouldn't lie to anyone. It's all about having all people understand the process. You as a marketing manager understand inbound marketing process. You have knowledge about the long sales cycle that's often a factor in the B2B tech industry. But educate the CEO and sales in inbound marketing. And the way I do that often is just stacking up the numbers to make it more comprehensible for sales and business decision makers. So, for example, if we have an ad budget of 10,000, we will probably with this certain CTR and CPM, you get 100 clicks. Of those 100 clicks, 20 people might become a lead. Of those 10, you will t 15 will be a qualified lead, a good lead to follow up on. And of those 15, 5 will become a meeting, and you will close perhaps 2 of those meetings, and the estimated deal size is this value. So if you're just stacking up the entire campaign in numbers, just for example, that might make it easier for business decision makers and sales-oriented people to understand the process and what's really a reasonable expectation from this campaign. Hope that answered the question. Here's a question. I have difficulties getting the sales team to show interest in our marketing campaigns. Any tips on how to show them the benefits of having a tight relationship between sales and marketing? That's this classic gap once again between marketing and sales. And it is not easy. It's more about communication than anything else. I would say if you ask the sales organization why they don't get engaged, you might get an answer that you can work on, but also showcase the difference between, like, it's hard to know the exact details here, but if the problem is that they're not engaged in the execution phase, following up on your digital leads, it might be as simple as engaging with them or involving them earlier on in the process. And sometimes it's just people, it's more like being kind to the salespeople. They want to feel involved. They want to have their say. So if you can discuss the content in the campaign, for example, with the sales guys, you can perhaps get them to feel more involved and make it easier for them to be following up on your digital leads, for example. Because if sales isn't, let's say that sales wouldn't be involved at all in marketing or following up on generated leads through your inbound marketing campaigns, then or the inbound marketing would be in vain to in one sense. So get them to understand that we will make their jobs easier. It will be easier to follow up on our digital leads, so to speak, than finding than sitting cold calling. And if they want to focus on existing customers and upselling possibilities, if that's the issue, that they don't want new contacts to follow up on because they're not good according to sales, then you might meet sales organization halfway and just, okay, dear sales guy, you want to focus on these 5 accounts. Okay, I will create an ABM, account-based marketing campaign towards these five accounts that you want to target. So it's not like the marketing manager always are right. Sometimes you need to meet them halfway and adapting your marketing initiatives to cater to the salespeople, sales team's needs. Last question here, I think. Regarding optimization between different channels, can you give us an industry benchmark when it comes to open rate, click rate, as well as CTR on LinkedIn? Definitely. But I wouldn't know where to start. CTR for LinkedIn is one ask here. I would say that, or one report I looked at a couple of days ago showed that 0.3 were some, it was a global summary of benchmarks on LinkedIn, but 0.3 was what that report stated. But I think it's pretty hard to get, you shouldn't listen too much on benchmarks like that. But 0.3 if you want a figure. You also asked for open rate, click rate on, I guess, email. And this is, you need to compare apples and apples. Email sendouts to your existing database, for example, usually have a lower open rate on email compared to nurture emails that are triggered by a form submission. Emails in a nurture flow triggered by a form submission, we usually say that 50% is something to aim at, but I think you should be happy with 35% open rate, and the click rate should be at least 5%, 5 to 10% in those kind of emails. It's very different when sending out emails to your existing database. I think it's best to establish your own benchmark when it comes to your existing clients. If you, let's say, you have a newsletter you send out to all your client or all your contacts on a monthly basis, do that without regards to any other benchmark and establish your own benchmark and try to improve that, I would say. Okay, there are some questions left. I need, but I don't have any more time. I would say that all questions that I haven't asked, you can send them to me in an email. You see my email address here. And if you want any help with your inbound marketing or just want to discuss your strategies or any specific question you might have, feel free to reach out and I would be happy to assist you. It's time to wrap up. So thank you for your time, everybody. And everyone will be getting a recorded version of this webinar as well. Also, everyone who's not here, everyone who's registered. So just reach out if you have any questions. Thank you for today, guys, and bye.